Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trophinet and welcome back to our Let's Replay series in Bioshock 2 where we try to delve a bit deeper. And on that same subject, I want to start off with, a bit of a problem I had. You might not notice it right now, but I couldn't save after the last episode. So I had to redo the entire last two episodes. I tried to get at roughly the same point. I think I got the same amount of gathers. I even stupidly forgot to research the two big daddies again when I fought them. But I did swap out a bit of my tonics and plasmids, so I'm going to show you that now. So yeah, thank you very much. So as you can see, I only upgraded telekinesis for now. And then the tonics we now have are actually sport boost, drill power, armored shell, keen observer, eavesdropper, and proud parent. But the other three are different. So instead of electric flash, I went with walking inferno, since we have way more ways to deal fire damage than we do electric flash. So electric damage, because in the previous game you had those electric bugs. We don't have that yet. We had electric gel, we had trap bolts, we all don't have that yet. So the only way to deal electric damage is by actually using electrobolt. But that's just really, really limited instead of the fire damage that we can do. I also went with scavengers because sometimes we do run out of supplies rather quickly. So we can search containers again, and then medical expert allows me to carry one more first aid kit. There we go. So we're still at the same point in the game aside from that. So we're gonna head further. I know I said last time we should focus on gathering first, but I thought we were in front of a different door, so that's the reason why I'm going to continue right now.
Ask yourself, Delta. You, who have suffered beyond measure at the hands of men like Ryan, what is the cost of paradise? To end pain, to end sin, what must we pay? Eleanor is my answer.
So you're gonna sacrifice your daughter instead of paying anything else. Yeah, sure. So here's another corpse that we can check out, but I'm first gonna try and clear out the area. Another thing I missed that I did find while I was replaying this bit is that I missed a rather important audio diary from Sinclair. So I'm gonna play you that right now. Farther to fall.
The kind of place you go to scratch an itch you're ashamed of, even in a town with no laws. But that's not why I favor it. The place started out as the Mason's Quarter, all builders and architects, proper as you please. And it just tickles me when someone in a fancy hat falls in the mud. Like a lot of the ladies down here, Siren Alley was born with a more respectable name, but only God remembers what it was.
So that is rather interesting. Siren Alley wasn't always Siren Alley. It was the Mason Quarters. I don't know what that Big Daddy is doing over there. He seems to be glitching out. So the architects and the builders were all stationed here. So these were offices instead of bars, etc. With a different name as well. The other thing is that I kind of failed to explain in the previous episode is that because of the same economic drop that caused Grace Holloway to shut down her bar, the people in Siren Alley, of what was, what became Siren Alley, actually started selling themselves and started, becoming prostitutes because they didn't find any other way to earn some money. And that's where Daniel Wales came in, of course. But we kind of fixed that already. 50 caliber rounds, we don't really need that. So yeah, this is an entirely different area. Kinda looks the same, that's why I was confusing it with what we had already done. Do have to be careful here, because there are a few splices and a camera. Don't need to research them again, but I think I can actually research the... Let's let them handle the brute splicer. There we go, hack the security. And research that a bit. Oh, hi! You were attacking me. Hi. Okay, why are you going upstairs? Never mind, that guy is taking a little sister. Hello? So So that's that. Let's put a spear in his head as well. I think he's going down. A bit of anti-personnel rounds might be handy. And there we go. Bruce Splicer taken care of. 5 trap rivets, that's not bad. Kinda wasted a lot of my anti-personnel rounds there. But that's the easiest way to take care of a Brute Splicer. Hello? Are you trying to hit me? Me? Take it easy. So we again have a lot of side area, so I do want to check out everything. But we're first going to have to clear out the rest of the splicers over there. Could do that with a stealthy spear shot to the face, though, because it seems like they... Oh, they probably all died because of the camera. That is perfect. Perfectamundo. Do I need anything else? Yeah, the pair bond mechanism. Explaining the bond between Big Daddy and Little Sister a bit further.
The pair bond is a success. If somehow an Alpha Series wanders too far from his little sister, our physical failsafe kicks in. A chemical trigger that induces coma. It is a symbiotic relationship enforced by the girl's pheromone signature. The first successful candidate was Delta, I believe. It is unfortunate that poor Dr. Suchong will not be here to raise a glass.
Yeah, because Suchong died in the construction of that bomb. And as he mentioned, of course, the more important bit in that conversation was that Delta was the first successful candidate. And of course, we are subject Delta. Interesting, isn't it? The Little Sister's Orphanage. So there's one here as well, the same as with... Fontaines in the original game, but I think it's high time we start setting up some traps, because we're gonna try out this corpse first. So we're pretty cornered off here, so if I just use a few cyclone traps around here, and that's the last one, let's swap back to anti-personnel rounds and gather Adam. And then I'm just gonna hide underneath the staircase. Maybe add a mini turret just right in the center of the place here. And then just keep with anti-personnel rounds.
Dirty hair.
Here we go. So he's dead. He's dead as well, it seems. It sounds like the Big Daddy is angry as well. Did we trigger the Big Daddy? Oh, stop doing that. There we go, nice little headshot. Okay, he died apparently. There's another spider splicer, because they have a very particular voice. Ooh, there's someone else up there as well. Ooh, do need to be careful. I think there's another... There we go. Seriously? There we go, another one. There we go, a quiet tonic fountain of youth. In today's rapture, water is everywhere. Take advantage of maintenance issues with the Fountain of Youth tonic and let that water wash your cares away. Standing in water slowly restores health and Eve. It's a very interesting one, but I think I'm going to wait with that one because it's one of the new ones and I really, really like it because it's a really nice idea to incorporate the water into the tonics. Because of course, as the tonic says, water is everywhere. So let's pick her up again. And let's see if any of the spider splicers have... Apparently they don't. would expect another organ, but apparently can't really find that here. Wondering if there is even a... I think there is. There should be another... a normal vending machine around here somewhere. Let's just quickly gather everything around here. Because that was a lot of splicers. Ow. Ow. They start having shotguns now, do they? No. Boom. Yeah, indeed. So let's check out that vending machine over there. Yeah, okay, so that's good. Let's check that out. Not really anything of interest. And let's put her in a vent. That big daddy is blocking my vent, but let's just take a look around and rescue our little sister. And then we have a fresh one right in the back. So goodbye, little girl. Go back to Tenenbaum. There we go. Let's swap to armor piercing. And quickly, let's start filming him. And then start it off with electrobolt, telekinesis, and a spear. There we go. I have the feeling I'm getting shot at again from somewhere else. There we go, let's focus on that. I think there's another one in my way. Okay, normal. Oh, whoa, 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 what the hell's going on? Oh, there's a turret over here. Take it easy, buddy. Oh, shit, that splicer was really annoying. That splicer almost fucked up everything. Okay, gather spears and search this bad boy. 26 armor piercing rounds, $53, and 2 mini turrets. That seems to be enough. And let's adopt you.
Are we together again, Dad?
Yes, we will be together again. Although I don't think I am who you think I am. But let's get you up on my back. And let's check out this horrible woman. We tried to fuck up everything. So, let's purchase a few first aid kits and Eve hypos, because I really, really need some. And then that's that. We do have a lot more extra atoms. Let's check out the Gatherer's Garden as well. Eve upgrade, we could do that, but I think it's high time we start buying a few more slots, especially for Headhunter. Because that would come in really handy to save some supplies. So let's buy another gene tonic slot. Put Fountain of Youth there for now. But I think I'm going to go for Headhunter. There we go. And now we have 120 left. So that's just enough to buy one of the upgrades. Or maybe... why can't I buy... you do not have the prerequisite plasmids to purchase this item. So, okay, yeah. So you need to buy the base version before you can buy the upgraded version. So let's go with Cyclone Trap 2. Charge up your Cyclone Traps with a variety of plasmid powers.
Upgrade your traps with plasmid power. Try out many combinations.
Because, yeah, there's a lot of combinations. I probably never even tried every one of them because I never really used a lot of Cyclone Traps. But they're actually really, really powerful. So let's try this out. Let's put a few around the corpse. No. Can I still? No. So we're done with the research on the spider splicer as well. So the other things we still need is probably security, if I'm not mistaken. And now that we're at it, I think there's a hidden area around here behind the back. Is there stuff that I can take off, or can we go? Yeah, we can go down completely. Nothing over here, but I think there's something here. Oh yeah, there we go. Vending experts. Enjoy a special discount at all of Rapture's vending machines. Reduces prices in vending machines. Not that interesting, of course, but a few more phosphorus bugs and trap rivets. And the requirements of Utopia.
Rapture. The keenest minds in the world, united under the ocean, yet somehow expected to subscribe to the same model of self-interest. Ryan could be staggeringly naive. As individuals, no matter how brilliant, each was a prisoner to his or her own ego, a sea of dreams in constant flux. But in Adam, their genes remain, ready to be tested against a moral vessel. Utopia cannot precede the utopian. It will exist the moment we are fit to occupy it.
So that's a very interesting assessment from Sophia Lam. So she says that the reason Rapture failed is because, of course, all those great minds have a humongous ego, and that doesn't work in a utopia, but Adam contains their genes. So if she somehow can combine all those skills into one person, say her daughter, that would make everything better, shouldn't it? That's the logic, at least. So that's what she kind of means with the family. She wants to bring everybody together by, of course, letting everybody die and using the atom that they produce to combine that in a single person that has all those skills. And that's why they want to worship Eleanor, because that would, well, that would be their new future. More shotgun shells. I think I'm going to have to cover this corpse a bit with traps. Let's put a few on the line here as well. And now we can actually combine these. So for example, if I equip Incinerate and walk towards a Cyclone trap, I can charge it with Incinerate. Doesn't take that much Eve, actually. So I'm going to put a few Electrobolt traps here as well. And then I actually never tried to combine that with Telekinesis, but I think I can. So that just makes it humongous. That's actually really cool. So that should blast them sky high, shouldn't it? So let's put the telekinesis on this one as well, and then incinerate on this one. Look at that. If people aren't gonna die right here, I don't know what should kill them. Let's put a few more trap rivets over here, and then just, well, let's just wait and see now, shall we? Gather, Adam. Angels remember mommy. So let's hide in this room, maybe? What is happening with that one? Whoa! Okay. Let's drill him to death. There we go. I am unzipping them. There we go. I think I can shake out. I think there's one near. Are you charging by the minute, are you? There we go. Yeah, ba-boom indeed. In your face. I think that's it. It's calming down. Thank you very much. Some of those traps were hilarious. That flaming spider splicer that flew all the way up to the orphanage sign. That was amazing. Pick her up. Thank you very much. And let's check out the corpses now that we're at Master Gatherer. Okay, I don't know why, but I heard a voice. Oh! Hi! He wants it. Just you right. No, 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 no. Let's take telekinesis because he's gonna throw something at me. Hello! Let's put that back in his face. Are you Now let's get that gas. Okay, I blew something else up, I think. Okay, and she's firing at me now as well. They keep coming, don't they? And there we have the effect of the headshots. That's, well, with the machine gun, you have a pretty high chance you're going to hit their head. Which comes in really, really handy sometimes. God damn it, should have taken the Eve hypo. Anything else I can scrounge around here? Searched her already, so shouldn't do that. So let's just buy a few more things. Because we still have the funds available. Especially on drill fuel, apparently. There we go. No refunds, no returns. And I could rush over there to the Temple of the Lamb, because that's where we need to be eventually. But, of course, we still have a lot of rooms that we haven't checked yet. And I'm wondering if we have missed any of those lovely, lovely paintings depicting scenes from the previous game. Doesn't seem like we have. So, first gonna head up and see how far we can get over here, because there's a few rooms in here as well. A corpse that I can't interact with. Anything around here? Yeah, okay, so we're gonna enter the room through this place. Thank you very much. Let's leave that Eve hypo over there. And another audio diary. Bury her memory.
Sinclair, I don't care how you accomplish Lamb's removal from the public eye. Indeed, I'd rather cease contact with you altogether. But allow me to make this plain. I don't want to see Lamb on the streets again, peddling her Bolshevik fever dreams to my people. Bury her memory, Sinclair. Bury it. And salt the earth.
So that's another confirmation that Andrew Ryan got Sinclair to put Sophia Lamb in prison, because we know she ended up there, and Andrew Ryan was behind that because he didn't like the competition. Non-believers are not welcome here anymore. And well, they kind of make that pretty clear with a hook through that woman's face. Another mini turret, so that's exactly what we're going to use at that corpse at the beginning of this room, because this is a nicely defensible position, by the way, so that's going to be our next objective, especially now that we have the drill fuel to keep our drill going. Anything else around here? I ever actually wonder if I actually checked this before. Headshots, my dear friend. There we go, blew that up. Oh, she's still alive. There we go, headshot. Headshots indeed. So now we're at the highest level. I'm just gonna quickly check around. What was that? Oh, there. Yeah, those headshots are really, really powerful. Don't think I could do much without that. Let's photograph that thing. And then let's electrobolt it, and then let's hack it. There we go. And there we go, A+. So that's gonna help us, because that's the only thing we haven't really researched until now. So let's hack this thing. Ooh, three. A bit more shotgun bullets. That's gonna be really nicely. Ooh, heavy rivets for 5. That was one heavy rivet, for some reason. In there with all the rest of the stuff. Let's buy all that. And there's another corpse here. I think there's more corpses than you actually can harvest, because I think... No, that's not what I wanted to check. Yeah, this is the last of the little sisters, if I'm not mistaken. But I think this one is pretty cool to defend. So let's just defend this corpse here first. That big daddy is just strolling on around those, so let's charge those all up with incinerate.
Right here.
Charge trap. And then the one over here, charge as well. So with that done, I don't have anti-personnel rounds. So let's just gather at him. And let's take the shotgun, and I'm gonna put myself over here in a corner. She doesn't look really safe in that scenario, but yeah, I think she's gonna be fine. I heard a spider splicer already. Maybe I should just stand in front of the door and just blast them when they get in. I think one step them. Yep, hello. Hello to you too.
Gonna cure me.
Cheers. Ow. Jesus Christ. I think he stepped on something. Hello? There we go, another spider splat. Is she done? Nope, you missed. You completely missed. So, pick
Daddy,
her back up.
Are you taking me home too?
Yes, I'm taking you home too. If home is a hole in the wall. Let's take all that. They look pretty beefed up. Thank you very much. Ooh, bill fuel. Thank you. Let's equip that again. Trap rivets. Yeah, that's not going to get much better now, is it? Another lockbox with a bit of money. And then somebody probably died here as well on the cyclone traps. But I don't really see any of those anymore. Do have to be careful now. Because, well, interesting. I think I'm going to booby trap this hallway. Because if I can get... Because yeah, we're going to get ambushed by Big Sister in a second. So I'm going to just set a few electrobolt traps down. Right here and right here. And that should help us out a bit with... lovely Big Sister. I have a bit of armor piercing rounds left. And of course, heavy rivets. Yeah. Here we go. Rescue the last little sister of the area. Which always means Big Sister trouble. There we go, 80 Adam. I'm gonna have to check out the research camera immediately as well, because, yeah, trouble ahead. Trouble ahead indeed. Panicking noises. Big Sister is almost there, prepare yourself. I just want to see where she's coming from. Hi. Hi, get over here. Ow, she just stabbed me. I'm gonna run over here. Where's she going? Where the hell is she? Hello? Oh, there she is. What the hell? Can I do that again? Uh-oh. Is the Big Daddy... Oh. The Big Daddy is fighting the Big Sister. That is interesting. Interesting. What the hell is going on? I think she's mad. But this gives me a very good opportunity, so 50% increased drill damage. Because of Big Daddy research. Did I? Ooh, okay, so that's an ability you haven't seen yet. She can actually take, how should I put this? She can grab nearby splicers and drain their energy, just causing them to, well, heal her instead of anything else. So 40 Adam, first aid kit, and $52. Let's search again. Two first aid kits. That's better, I suppose. There we go. Lead head splicer. Kind of hit him with a spear, apparently. But that was pretty nice.
Who is it?
Who is what? I'm not here. Oh, the hack dart. I'm not here at all. What the?
Hey! I'm trying to concentrate! So...
Hi!
No more!
That must have hurt. No, you shall not. So I got a bit of research on that Big Daddy as well, which is interesting. Because, of course, I never actually did much against that Big Daddy's Eve Hypo over here. So now, let's continue our scouting of the upper area. So back at the upper area, so let's take a look around, because we never went around this bend over here. I think I'm going to just try a few normal rivets at the moment. Ooh, anti-personnel rounds. Always handy. Is there anything else here? I know there should be another hallway here. Although that does seem to just loop around back to where we hacked that turret over here, so... Oh, there's a room over here as well. Lamb's operation.
Lamb's followers are blinded by her promises. But it's clear that this religion she's cooked up is an elaborate front for some insane science experiment. She's twisting these girls into slaves, bringing Adam back to Lamb's science facility, Fontaine Futuristics. I've got to find it. I've heard the splicers mumbling that Alexander is the ferryman.
Alexander is the ferryman. There's a few very interesting things from our pal pen Mark Meltzer there. So he confirms that Sophia Lamb is gathering Adam at Fontaine Futuristics for some insane science experiment. So we need to head to Fontaine Futuristics eventually. And the ferryman is Alexander. The only Alexander we've heard so far is, of course, Gil Alexander. And he is apparently still alive as well. So we're going to meet Mr. Alexander as well. That sounded like a turret firing up. So yeah, over there apparently. That splice is getting attacked by my turret. So that's the upper areas. I think there's not much else here aside from the heavy rivets over there. Kind of missed. Thank you very much. And on that note, I'm going to end the episode. So next up, we're going to probably confront Simon Wales in the Temple of the Lamb eventually. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!